working on, but you know, just some general.
Which game is it?
That Tinker game loss.
Okay, this one. You still are playing unranked games. Is it just because of your toxic MMR?
Yeah, I haven't been playing ranked at all.
All right. So last time when we went over to Tinker, let me just check really quickly what we discussed in the Tinker. We said you need to farm a lot more. You need to pre-aggro. Okay, that was the main two main things because I can't remember. Were you fighting constantly, like constantly fighting?
Yeah, that match was actually, remember, it was a, I think it was a
Better get
cup
ready.
match.
Ah, yes.
Templar assassin.
So it's a bit different. This is just a normal match that I decided to play Tinker. And yeah, I pretty much played, you know, normally.
All right. So you're gonna be up against an invoker, I assume.
Actually, TA.
Okay. So talk
Wait,
me.
actually, no, I'm not sure. I don't remember.
Tell
Maybe
me.
it was a poker.
Tell me a bit about this item build right here.
Was just a bottle rush. GG branches.
Why though?
Because I feel safer with the bottle, because I feel like it's not that hard to last hit without the null.
It's not about last hitting, it's about your survivability. Also, it is a little bit about last hitting, but it's mostly about your survivability. Without the null talisman, you're not very survivable. But you notice how I didn't actually say this is bad. I actually asked you what's your reasoning behind it, because I actually think this isn't so bad an idea against depending on what kind of a matchup you are. Like if you were up against an invoker, this is okay. Going for a bottle rush is okay, simply because nobody's actually. Yeah, 2.8. Nobody's in the 2.8K MMR. Nobody's actually gonna pressure you in the mid lane too much. Invoker isn't gonna harass you or anything like that. So I think going for a bottle rush isn't too bad. Although you just want to make sure that if there is a Ricky or somebody in the okay, they are pressuring you. Never mind. I mean, they're putting two people in the mid, sort of, but I think it's more of a contest of the mid lane,
Yeah,
like
it was.
more rather than the Pudge actually harassing you. So never mind. But yeah, if there's a Ricky or for some reason you think the mid lane is going to be strong, so then you probably don't want to rush bottle. So yeah, it's good. It's not too bad.
Yeah, this game, I followed your advice, you know, I just started leveling like I used to,
Yeah.
maxing March and trying to utilize jungle stacks. I was gonna stack myself, but then I saw that CM is jungling, and I just asked her to stack me some and leave me some camps. And she said she would.
It's funny that you actually went for the bottle rush, because I've been theorizing this on Tinker for a while now, that against e easier matchups, because he's got such a high base.
Mission middle.
Go for the rune, go for the rune. The reason why it does work is simply because if you don't have too much to harass somebody to harass you, you can actually quite easy to get away with it, and Tinker doesn't really need that null talisman too much, and you can benefit a lot from the bottle rush. So
Yeah, I used to lose a lot. I started going more for null when I didn't have March, because then you like really need to get those last hits. And when I would go like straight up max fucking laser and rockets, then I would really get null, because I just.
You traded a pudge hit. Sorry, you traded a last hit for a pudge hit. Not really ideal. Got hooked, made a really good decision. You could have played this slightly better. Always remember that March of the Machines. You wanna try to, like, not walk in the direction that the march is going in.
Perpendicular.
Like no. Like you decided to walk in this direction. You decided to walk in this direction, which was the right thing to do. If you'd been walking in this direction, that would have
Well,
been a bad
yeah, what
thing.
I thought you meant like down.
Yeah. Oh no. The direction you were walking was perfect. It was really unfortunate that you got hooked. And if you died here, I would have told you, like, remember Null Talisman? It would have saved your life. It's fine. I think you could have avoided getting hooked
Radiant's
there.
mid tower is
But
coming online.
That sucked.
sorry
And
about
I
that.
would have got Sunstrike
Sorry
too.
about
I
that.
knew they had a ward, and I knew there was an invoker, so I wanted to make a weird
That
path.
was a super greedy thing that you did, going for the rune.
No, I wasn't. I wasn't going for the rune. I just wanted to make a weird path because I knew they had a high ground ward because he had hooked earlier with no vision.
Okay.
He had thrown a hook in my direction, and I knew there was an invoker who would Sunstrike, so I tried to do a weird path. But then that TA came. I was gonna just go into the jungle right there,
You
but
are using the wave to the right timing for the push, but then you're not. You didn't pull the creep wave. You didn't stack the camp. This is the first time you're doing the stack, and you're
not
not.
even. I didn't even stack here. I was just like looking, and I was gonna put farm it.
So just a quick one. You wanna stack these camps. Level 3 in March of the Machines. You're gonna end up using 2 point. You're gonna end up waiting too long. Level 4 in this. You can literally just put down two of them and then just go back to base. It's completely fine. I mean, go wherever you want because level 4 March of the Machines is just gonna kill it, kill both camps fully. Doesn't matter how much it's stacked. Well, it does matter how much it's stacked because what the hell is going on with me? Because if there's too many auras, magic resist auras, then there will be some creeps, some big creeps, which are not gonna die. So just a couple of hits on the big creeps will do it, but mostly the March of the Machines level 4 will clear out these camps. You always want to stack them because you definitely missed out an entire creep wave here while you were taking that those two camps, and it was worth it, almost equal. But if you'd stacked it, then it would have been even better.
Right, yeah. And I did get
And
there in stack
you
time.
missed
I don't
all
know why
these.
I
Now you're
didn't.
missing all of these last hits. That's pretty bad. They were not even underneath the tower. You literally just look at that. Look at how many blasters you get. That's just not acceptable.
Right there, they like fucking checkmated me.
They should
Like,
have
she shot a fucking arrow at one air. Like, I dodged the arrow, but then I got hit.
The thing is, when you have a Pudge in the enemy team or a Mirana, you always wanna make sure that you have a high ground ward in the enemy team, enemy side, so that you can. Just so that you can, wow, that was poorly played as well. Just so that you can avoid getting hooked and arrowed. Now, if the CM is going with you and she is stacking for you already, so what you should have done right here is you should have pulled this to stack this, and she could have stacked this, and then
I
she
didn't
could
know if she was gonna stack or farm. She was farming and like not like, and when I asked her for a stack, she made me like half a stack. Like I thought she was gonna actually stack for me, but she made me like she pulled a stack, made a double stack, and took a big creep. So it was really like a half-ass double stack. So then I didn't even know if she was gonna go for the stack or if she was gonna go for the farm. I just wanted to
Yeah,
stack it.
so at this point, you really should have been farming the lane then because you wasted because there's already a jungler, and right now you're in a very, very dangerous position. You're lucky to die.
I was just desperate to finish my boots. I didn't want to get caught out again by like a gank from
Okay, yeah,
like.
that's fine. That's fine.
I was almost done, and I was like, "Fuck it! I'm just gonna do this safely in the jungle because I'm scared of getting ganked again."
Yeah, you got pretty decent timing on the boots as well. You definitely want to just
With
wait.
two deaths, considering.
Yeah. This does look really greedy because. Oh shit! I pressed the jump ahead button. You know, this is far ahead.
Yeah, that was a trade. I killed him first, though, so I got.
Oh, but the thing is, like, you've got March of the Machines maxed out, right? You don't want to max out this. You want to have 1 point in heat-seeking missile because look at this. 1 point in heat-seeking missile gives you 125 damage, whereas every other point in after the first point in laser, every point gives you 80 damage, right? So after level 1 laser, you want to put level 2 in heat-seeking missile. Sorry, after leveling up laser at level 1, at God damn it. You need,
Level two.
yeah, before you level laser up for the level 2, just put a point in heat-seeking missile because you're gonna get more damage from heat-seeking missile for that one level rather than the second point in laser.
Right, yeah. I just thought that, since like for lane harassing, I just got used to maxing laser since like it's I'm just gonna use laser anyways. I'm not gonna use both, or else I'll have no mana.
Yeah, you miss the entire damage out on the laser to the TA.
I was just trying to be safe and not have.
That was the one where you died, right? Or not? The Invoker was the one where you died. So you definitely need to understand that when you go for a max martial machines, you are farming. You're not fighting. So you need to be farming and not fighting. And you were definitely fighting right here against an Exhort Invoker, no less. So you're lucky that you killed him. You're lucky you killed him at all. So you want to be utilizing jungle as much as possible. At this point, you got maxed out. You got maxed out March of the Machine, so you want to be utilizing as much jungle farm as possible, because you want to leave your other people to farm the lanes. It's going to be really beneficial if somebody can take mid farm at this point. And also, you don't want to be fighting until you get a Blink Dagger. You don't want to be, like, with this positioning that you have, is decent. You're pretty far back.
I don't want to be anywhere near fights. I mean, I was kind of close there.
You did make a movement towards them a bit, like, aggressively. Pudge could have hooked you at that point. So, you can see that.
Yeah, the only reason I even actually went for the lasers is because he just hooked Ursa to finish him off.
So you're pushing out the lanes constantly. That's nice and all, but the thing is that your other people could be taking this farm, and the reason why they're not is because you're farming there. So, also, you saw the Invoker was pushing this lane right now, so making this move is really, really dangerous. Even though you got out pretty quickly, but...
Do you really think that Invoker could have killed me there, even if I lasered him?
Yeah, you lasering Exhort Invoker has got loads of damage, right? He's, let's see, he's got... this one... Okay, never mind, it's 4 level. Wait, what level are you? Oh, wow. I forget that's not a mid-invoker. He's got loads of... Even if you laser him, at these guys... he did go for you, but I think he didn't look at the map. Or what was the issue there? Yeah, because he could have quite easily cold snap and Force Spirit. And if he cold snap and Force Spirits you laser him, you probably start to use a spell. You were there for a very short period of time, so you're lucky they didn't have any ward or vision there, because I think Sunstrike at this point is gonna be 300 nearly pure damage, and then let's see, you have 600, 700 HP after that.
Between
ward spirits and cold snap. Keep in mind, Force Spirits do keep taking away your armor as well, so they keep doing more and more damage. So even if you laser Invoker, which is 4.5 seconds, the Cold Snap.
They could still lock me down enough to get a Sunstrike on.
The Cold Snap is going to last exactly 4.5 seconds as well. So yes, he's going to be blind for the entire duration of Cold Snap, but you're not going anywhere for the entire duration of Cold Snap. And right after Cold Snap wears off, as soon as you try to TP, that's 3 seconds, Invoker is right clicking you with like minus 10 armor while these guys are right clicking you. You were guaranteed dead there, for sure. Alright. So just small one mistake you made so far is, two mistakes you made so far. Number one, going for a bit aggressive farm right here as well. You've been going for like aggressive farm within a Tinker who does not have Blink. Going in for, that's one thing, going in for max martial machines, you are constantly, you're looking for kills. So that's not really an optimal thing, because you should be farming. And thirdly, you are farming the lanes too much. Because keep in mind, you can farm two camps of jungle. Immediate with two March of the Machines, you can farm two camps of the jungle at one time. So you can literally, you can take go tower, TP to this tower, go over here, throw down March of the Machines, refresh, rearm, TP to this tower, walk over here, throw down March of the Machines on these two, and literally you've cleared up four jungle camps before even a minute is over, and then you go back to base. So that is really efficient farming, and then you're completely out of harm's way. Everybody else can take the jungle farm, etc., etc. Like farming this camp is completely useless because it's just, well, it's not completely useless. It is useful, but it's just one camp where you can be taken to. But the way you did it is really good because you were already on the way. You were right there. So yeah, I like it that you stacked there and everything. It's pretty decent, but you should be farming the jungle a bit more. Like this movement right here, just definitely don't agree with it. Even though Ursa was with you, everybody from the map was missing, and I've constantly been checking the map.
I checked. I remember that time.
I kind of checked their movements as well, and I did not see where the hell they were. So Pudge ends up being top, but he could have been caught at that time. So, but now you've got a Bling, and that was a bit too aggressive again. You're not afraid of them, which is pretty bad. They are afraid of you. I don't know why.
He should be. I've been shitting on him.
I mean, like, it doesn't matter. He's even got a point in Vex now, so he can literally blow you up immediately. Cold Snap, Four Spirits, he's already got. He should have...
and then a Meteor, right.
Yeah, Meteor plus Cold Snap on top of you, you're dead, guaranteed. So Invoker just doesn't realize that he's stronger than you. He's stronger than you in the sense that if you try to man fight him, he'll destroy you. But you're stronger than him just because you've got that refresh, rearm, blink into the T-line, and any contact can look for you, find you.
Yeah, that's the reason why, because I'm never going to sit there and manfight him.
Now what you're doing is really nice. They're trying to push down the tower, you're blinking in the ship queuing, blinking in the...
And I denied it. That was a nice deny, too.
Yeah,
because he alacritied himself to finish it off. I lasered him, denied it.
Too close to the TA. She can actually...
I kill her. She digged the team coming.
That's good, but she could have Melstriked you and killed you. Well, she couldn't have killed you, but she could have Melstriked you, and then there could have been other people there, so you don't want to take harassment.
That chance.
So, but it's fine. Yeah, you did a good job. So what you're doing, what you did right there at that tower, you were pushing out the wave constantly while they were trying to defend the tower. Your team doesn't lose anything. You don't lose anything. You're actually farming the wave while you're making it really hard for them to push the tower. You're making them spend a lot of resources. To push that tower, so that you're doing a lot, you're having a huge impact by doing that. Now what you're doing I don't agree with, because once again you're pushing this wave in constantly, and look at where the rest of your team is. The rest of the team has basically recluse to into their own jungle, because they literally can't farm anywhere else. They can farm the top lane, they can somewhat farm the mid lane, but the bot lane is completely out, and they can't really do there. So you should...
That was like a really bad play there. I thought I thought Ursa was coming down, and then he actually just left, and then I realized I was on myself and I got killed.
Nice refresh, rockets. Nice. So far, so good.
And then I get killed.
How did you get killed? Oh, why? That was a mistake you made. You stop there to throw the...
Because I thought we were fighting, that's the thing. I thought we were fighting, but there's a TP out.
I really do think, because this guy didn't have Cold Snap... Oh, he did have Cold Snap.
He did, I got Cold Snap.
I was pretty sure he used it on someone, never mind. Yeah, because... okay, never mind. I thought you had Cold Snap.
I was already, earned and Cold Snapped.
It's fine.
Not really. I mean, the positioning was bad. I was just, I didn't have communication with my team.
It's fine. It's not entirely your fault. The play was correct. I probably would have gone for the same thing because your team was...
I feel like if Ursa came through, me and Ursa on our own could have probably
Timber
pulled
something. Timber was there as well, I think. Timber was there as well. I'm pretty sure Timber was there as well.
Well, Ursa was up top, close by, and then he took it.
Oh, never mind. So you were there all by yourself. I'm pretty sure I saw Timber.
He was there, and then he TP'd out Ursa.
I was mistaken. I thought I saw Timber.
Yeah, I saw all this movement as I was TPing in. I was like, all right, yeah, my team's over here. And then Ursa TP's out right instantly as soon as I came in.
Yeah.
The urn cold snap is fucking OP, man.
Yeah, I mean, it's fine. To be honest, just don't worry about it.
Well, anyways, I felt like I played, like, after this point, you know, after, like, the little mistakes in the beginning of, like, taking people's farm and this and that. The main reason why, like, I focus a lane, like I did bottom, is to put pressure in that lane when I see that the enemy team's, like, putting pressure on our tower. So I put pressure on their towers to maybe create some space for my team, even though I am taking out a lane.
That idea is correct, but while you were pushing bot lane, nobody was really pressuring any of your other lanes. Your team was just sort of farming any other wherever they could, which wasn't a lot, which weren't a lot of places. So, you, right here, even right now, all you're doing is just taking farm from your cores. It's not a lot. This skill is really good, obviously, but other than that, you're not really pushing this lane right now. Isn't really achieving that much, especially when you do go for that dragon build. You should be taking part in doing this exactly what you did just now. That's what you should be doing. You shouldn't be pushing too much, because you are going for that, you know, kill people build. So how are you going to kill people if you are like constantly trying to farm waves and farm lane? Like every time you go to the lane to push somewhere.
Well, I feel like it's easier for me to kill people if they're spread out, and if I push a lane, someone's gonna have to go there to defend. That means that they're not gonna be so.
Yeah, but together. They're gonna be under the tower most likely, and then you have to dive them, and then anybody can TP and kill you. I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying. The idea is correct, and that's maybe sometimes will work on the, in your games if nobody comes to help their allies.
Right, but I don't mean even the people that come to defend. Like, the other people that don't come to defend now have one person less that could be possibly with them.
Look at what you did right here, right? This is the correct movement. Like, you've been playing so far, you've been playing a pretty decent game, apart from just taking too much of your team's farm and pushing way too much. You see the Murata, you TP here, few spells, boom, she's dead, that's it, Hodge can't react. That's what you want to be doing. But when you defend, when you are pushing the lane like this, the other issue with Tinker is you have absolutely no vision right here, right? The biggest issue for you, if you keep pushing this lane in, they know you've been pushing this lane in. They can quite easily set up a trap for you. Two people.
Right, set up right a Tinker Ward or something.
Don't even need a Tinker Ward, right? You're gonna, if you want to kill that person, like you killed the TA, you were standing here for a very long time, throwing down a March of the Machines right in front of her face. Throwing down spells in front of her face. So it could have been two people right behind her waiting for you to dive the TA, and then they kill you. And then basically once they kill you, that's it. You're never going to push again because you're scared. Right? And even if you they can do the same thing again. So
right.
It's something that you want to... Pushing is great, but the only time you should be pushing is if you either have vision of the area, which in this case you don't, or you know exactly where the five enemies are. And they are like sort of pushing your lane, but they're not really at the tower, so you want to be pushing out their other lane so that they have to consider this, that okay, if we start taking this tower and Tinker is pushing our other lane, so we really have to like make this trade. We're gonna take this tower, but we're gonna lose our tower as well. So that's what you want to be doing. And obviously you're not literally just sitting there pushing the wave, you're actually we going to be able to TP immediately and spread. Like right now, what you should do is go and help this team, your teammates out. Forget TA. You should not, yeah, there you go. Might be a little late now. Too aggressive. Holy shit, you're so aggressive. That positioning, I definitely wouldn't have done that. But I guess it works out for you. You threw out, yeah, that's super aggressive, dude. Let's see again. You TP here, throw down our rocket. Refresh. Yeah, I would have definitely blinked here. Because right, you literally blinked into three people. Invoker was in vision, you're gonna go for Invoker. You should have, when you refreshed and rearmed. Alright. You blink here, you throw down a rocket, you rearm. You should throw down the rockets first and then assess the situation. You throw down the rocket first, then you blink right here, and then you laser this guy or dagger this guy or whatever. That was super aggressive. That was very, very dangerous movement what you did there. Now you've got blink online, blink somewhere. too late. I mean, I'm not really late things, but it's kind of like that. Yeah, why am I looking at this? Alright. So just like this, right now it's okay. Invoker is dead, you see one person, so it's not too bad. Don't want to be pushing out waves underneath close to their tower when you don't have it. Right now you know three people are mid. Right? You know three people are mid. If you go on this Invoker, it's fine. If you even go on the Mirana, it's fine. Right? Wow, you lived?
Yeah.
I want to see that. Okay, he surprised you. He surprised me. You should have seen him there, to be honest, because you knew he was there. You saw him on the minimap.
And I am kind of cautious when I blink to that like side of the tree area because I know I'm exposed.
Yeah, because you should have blinked here in these trees. Yeah, he sort of stood there. You could have lived. Oh well. Radiant's top tower is taking hits. Yeah, once again, you're constantly pushing out bot tower. It's not really achieving much, because if you notice, like, the tower actually pushes out that wave, so it's like chipping away slowly. It's not really achieving much because you're not actually safely able to push the tower because you don't know if there are people there or not, so you can't push that wave the next.
Well, it's mostly for the space and the farm.
Yeah, but the tower is automatically pushing. Nobody's pushing out this wave from bot. The tower pushes it out because you can't actually push the next wave in underneath the tower.
I'm fine with that. I want the wave to push back out so I can kill the creeps again.
Yeah, but you basically look at what you're doing, right? You're basically taking up the entire. Both of these lanes are yours, right? You're super lucky in this game that it's an Ursa. He doesn't need a lot of farm. But if it wasn't an Ursa, look at the net worth, right? You are at 16,000 net worth. Actually, I'd like to look at total net worth. The Radiant is 3,000 ahead in net worth and more in XP. They've got a little bit of kill score on you. But look at the farm right here. You're at 16,000, top of the net worth, 3,000 ahead almost of the Luna. It's more like 1,300 actually, sorry. 1,300 ahead of the Luna. But then look at this. Four of them are right underneath you, all above your teammates.
Yeah.
Right? The teammates are almost all at 8,000 gold. Literally, they're all at 8,000 gold because even the support, every single one of them are taking the scraps of gold that are left over from your pushing, from your farming. And right here, what the issue is that every single time that you die, you're feeding away too much gold. Look at your items. You've got super good items right now, right? You've got really, really lots and lots of gold, but you're only one person. The rest of your team doesn't do much, right? This guy went for a... I don't know if I agree with that. This guy has only... Bloodstone, right? This guy needs a lot of farm to be effective. He's got only Bloodstone. Nobody cares about CM. And this guy, for some reason, also has Bloodstone.
That was, like, one of the reasons we lost this game was because Timber disconnected a little, like, fucking 5 minutes after this or something. He left. And then, like, we actually stayed holding for a while because I was still, like, fucking shit up.
Yeah, I mean, I play a ton of Tinker, but I think I really don't know how to better explain to you how like you have to know. It's like a feeling, like you know when you're taking your carry's farm, right? Like if you play carry, then you should know. All right, this is definitely me taking his farm. He can farm here because this wave is constantly pushed out. The bottom wave is constantly pushed out. You guys should have been owning this entire part of the map. What these guys should have been doing, what your team should have been doing, is your entire team should have been pushing here. They should ward up this entire map area. They should start trying to take this tower. They take this tower. They take Roshan. Then they go over to mid lane and they start taking mid lane. All the while, what you're doing is you're in your own jungle. this is the dangerous area because the enemy team is somewhere around here, but you're doing like safe shit with your blink dagger and your march of the machines, and you're maybe gonna die a couple of times, more than you've died now, probably, I don't know. You're probably gonna have less kills than you have, maybe, I don't know. But you're definitely gonna have, these guys are definitely gonna be much, much higher, and also you're gonna have much more objectives being done. You're going to be farming in areas which are dangerous, so you're going to be taking basically your entire team, four teammates are taking this farm, you're taking this lane farm and some of the jungle farm, so all you need is either a ward here or a ward here, so, and also you're deterring the team, enemy team, from taking this tower because you guys are firstly pushing here, so they are basically creating a lot of space for you to be able to keep pushing out this way. That's the way it should be going. But instead, what's going on?
Now I understand why you're saying that I shouldn't play Tinker, because first off, my team would never listen to me if I would say such things.
Yeah, well, like
they would just do their own fucking thing, and I would have to go and take their shit regardless.
The other issue is, like, if you are taking this farm, then they actually don't want to push in here because it's like the dangerous lane for them. There's not a lot of vision area. Like, it's just dangerous. And also, you're leaving them in their own jungle, so obviously they're gonna farm their jungle. If they stay here, they're gonna farm this jungle, but farming this jungle also means that they're pushing out this way, which means they're gonna take this tower. But farming this jungle, they're not gonna go all the way over here to push this tower. So that's one of the, you know, advantage disadvantage things. So you're definitely taking away too much farm of your team, so that's the main issue right here. Right, I see what the movement is. You left the bot lane, you stopped pushing, and your whole team, is slowly, like, the issue here.
That's so true, man. Oh my god, they just see farm, they're like, oh my god, let's go.
Yeah, but the problem is that Ursa is still farming the jungle, because you are not farming the jungle, so you should take over the jungle, so it will actually force the Ursa to go farm somewhere else, and it will kind of automatically push them to sort of push out the mid lane and go to this lane, and hopefully if you start taking over this side of the map, they won't be on this side. They'll start going on this side of the map.
Yeah, so you don't even have to say nothing, just subconscious. Yeah,
you don't even have to say anything to them because they'll have no option. They will tilt a little bit because you will die a few times on this lane. What? Why did you do that?
Why did I do what? Constantly sheep it?
No, why did you dig on the,
Oh, it was a mistake.
Okay.
I dig on the creep, right?
Then it's fine, because if it was a mistake, then it's fine. Small efficiency thing that you could have done right here. When you TP'd to this creep right here, you shouldn't have blinked onto this area. You should have just stayed there a little bit, back in the fog. Then what you could have done is you could have thrown out a heat-seeking missile, blinked in, hexed the invoker, refresh, rearm, use another heat-seeking missile, dag in.
Are you sure he wouldn't hear the sound of the heat seeking?
No, you can't hear he wouldn't have seen it coming. He would have blinked before that. But it's fine.
He was like on his toes, that invoker, because I was like literally bullying him. So like whenever he would see a slim chance of me coming, he would like blink away.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
So I wanted to be super safe and just blink and sheep right away.
That's fine. Comes with experience, it's fine. Play it safe, Alright, let's see this. Again, the super aggressive blink. No, you don't want to do that. I know your whole team is there, and there's no chance at all that you will die here. There's absolutely zero chance that you're going to die here. Absolutely zero. 100%.
We just got to make it habit.
You need to make it habit. Blink here, away from these guys. All your spells, even what level is it?
Well, I was just like thinking that Mirana was going to leap away, so I can't be too crazy far. I might not get her. And then she does.
She leaps away once. You can leap away 10 times.
That's true.
Also, she's got a... does anybody have detection? She was... I think she was...
Pot of multi, yeah.
No. I think she was... Yeah, dusted. She was dusted. So, yeah, you could have chased her quite easily. But, yeah, too aggressive. You need to have a better positioning, blink positioning. Don't just tunnel vision and look for a, you know, kill opportunity. This is good movement right here, what you're doing right now. Look at where your team is. Your team is pushing the tower, the mid tower. You need to push other lanes. Like, your team doesn't need you right now. They're all dead. What you're doing is what you should be buy equipment. Someone dropped out like a kid in school. Oh, Timber, so you're gonna pause? What? Save to leave? What?
Why? He, that's what he does. That's how he loses this game. He leaves for some reason.
Let's look at their items. This guy is farming pretty fast.
Oh, this is the reason. He's the reason we really lose, because the Luna actually farmed up.
Yeah, the Luna is farming really, really fast, really, really well. Let's see, the Invoker. Invoker is pretty farmed as well. TA is gonna get BKB, and then she's gonna completely counter you. I think one fight would have happened in a way that Miranda would have ulted, and they would have initiated on you guys, or just two or three of you guys, and then you guys would have lost this game anyway, regardless of Timbersaw. If you guys have a Ursa as carry, Ursa does not scale very well. Ursa needs to finish the game by about 40 minutes max, because after 40 minutes, Ursa will just get fighted the shit out. Even with BKB, Ursa will get disabled by touch. Even with BKB, or he doesn't even have BKB. He's not even going to poke BKB. So without BKB, he's definitely dead. Guaranteed because of the Pudge plus Invoker. So that's the only carry you've got. And after that, you guys just have you for the push and stuff. And if your team is dead, you're not going to do anything. So I think this game would have been lost because you guys did not push early on. The Ursa was farming jungle too much. You guys weren't pushing too much. Could have been attributed a little bit to the fact that you were taking up this lane, which was supposed to be pushing, but then they could have easily pushed mid lane. The tower is tier 1 bloody tower is still there. And then that could have been attributed to the fact that there's fucking no wards on the map, so you can't actually go anywhere without vision or know where the people are. So I think this was a lost game anyway. Not just because of the draft, but because of the team people as well. Your support was pretty shit, your carry was pretty shit. They didn't push enough, they didn't push objectives. They picked a lineup which was early game against a lineup which was super late game, and they still didn't achieve anything. So, and they're like, look at the kill score, they were losing. So, yeah, I think this was a lost game. Look at this, 110. That's the old solo carry you guys have. I don't know what kind of 2218 team you're like, bracket you're in, that you've got one carry instead of five carries. But,
oh man, it's either five carries or like.
I guess this guy's also a carry.
No, yeah, he didn't buy a single ward that whole game.
Yeah, Necro's also a carry, and this guy apparently.
But the thing that got me mad that I think that could have changed the game is if Necro got an axe and ulted someone important.
I think that they'll just take one of them out, because look at them. They've got a multi-core lineup. When you have a multi-core lineup, you wanna go for the early push. You wanna get the game finished early on, so that their cores can't actually farm well.
Because yeah, but by end game, do you see the difference in the net worth with Luna? If you got Luna, it would have been huge for us.
Yeah,
we probably could have gotten axes and shit.
You can't get Luna though. That's the thing. Like, when she pops BKB, you're useless. This guy's useless. This guy's useless. This guy's useless. Ursa is the only one, and then Ursa doesn't even have BKB, and he's gonna get super kited by. Like, this guy's slow, this guy, even she can, like, stun him. Let's see what she's going to, even she can stun him or burst it out. There's no way.
Oh, but eventually she can only BKB for 5 seconds, and I can sheep lock her before she pops BKB.
Even if you do manage to do that, you are going to have to get into very aggressive area range to sheep her. And if her team is with her, if she makes a big blunder, mistake, that's the only way you get her. Because even right. If you sheep her, the sheep is 2.3.5 seconds. And that's very long. That's a fairly long time. But their entire team, if they're with them, then they will actually kill you quite immediately. You don't have BKB. You have no survivability after that. You're not going to blow her up really quickly. She's super tanky. And in 3.5 seconds, there's absolutely no way that you guys kill her. She comes back out.
I had E-Blade at one point, too. So
it doesn't matter. Even E-Blade doesn't matter. Even E-Blade, there's no way you kill her with these items. There's no way you kill her in 3.5 seconds, even if your entire team...
Not in 3.5 seconds. Probably more like 6 seconds with, like, three sheeps.
The thing is, the moment you... If she's alone, okay, yeah, sure. but you're never going to get the rearm and another sheep because somebody in this team is going to start hitting you. You're never going to get the second rearm off. And 3.5 seconds, you don't kill her. Instead, you've managed to get all five of these teammates on top of Luna. She's going to come back out. She's going to pop BKB. She's going to pop her Satanic. She's going to pop her Manta. She's going to give you full health, and you're all dead from the
clear. Yeah, that's pretty much.
So that's there's no way you were winning this game. Not the way you guys played it. It's too. This guy played really, really bad, and then the supports really did